Hey Bowtie Nation, Joseph Hogue here and starting a new video series on the best stocks to buy in 2022 for major upside surprises. We'll be focusing on stocks the market hasn't seen yet, like possible takeovers, earnings surprises, and the big headlines. And starting us off with one of my favorite stock ideas for the year, the potential for shares of Groupon to be bought out by Amazon or Google. Google already tried acquiring Groupon before it issued stock in 2010. By then, Groupon had taken off on its daily deal emails, and both Google and Yahoo wanted to buy the company. Groupon turned down a $6 billion offer and went public a year later at a $16.6 billion valuation. While the ride since hasn't been good, I think Groupon could be one of the best stocks to buy in 2022. I'll show you why shares are undervalued, how much I'm investing, and why it could get another acquisition offer. You know, we can't get started though without that special shout out to all you out there in the nation. Thank you for spending a part of your day to be here. If you're not part of that community yet, just click that little red subscribe button. It's free and you'll never miss an episode. If you want to see more of the stocks I'm buying, I'm revealing the top 5 stocks in my own portfolio in a free report. These are the 5 biggest stock positions I'm holding, stocks to benefit from the biggest trends over the next decade. So make sure you check out the link I'll leave in the description below. As for Groupon, it emerged quickly as the first mover in that daily deals market for local businesses and used to be the hottest thing a decade ago. But the company has struggled with acquisitions and just that trend to e-commerce versus the traditional local retailers that it works with. Now, sales were already falling and then got crushed during the pandemic, falling to just over $1 billion in the last 12 months. The company makes between 30 to 35% on the deals it sells, which is a strong take rate, but you can't make anything if people can't get out for those deals. What I really like here though, is that you see that in 2018 through 2020, even on revenue as high as $2.6 billion, the company wasn't able to turn a profit. Net income slid to negative, but on a massive restructuring, lowering costs across the board, Groupon has been able to produce positive earnings on just $1.1 billion in sales over the last year. Now, the company discontinued some of its non-performing segments last year, including its physical goods store, so it's going back to that core advantage in advertising. Analysts expect the company to report earnings growth of 42% over the next year to $2.09 a share on a stabilization in revenue just over $1 billion. Now that means the shares are trading at just 12 times on a price to earnings basis and 0.69 times sales. Even better though, and a big reason I've been buying shares is the company's balance sheet. Now Groupon has $477 million in cash against just $233 million in long-term debt. And remember, this is only a $750 million company, so that means a third of this stock's value is backed by cash. Shares were as high as $64 each just last March, and more than 15% of the shares outstanding are borrowed and shorted by short sellers. That means any kind of a stabilization in sales or an upside catalyst could produce that short squeeze that takes the price even higher. And the first catalyst I'm watching could be a new deal with Google announced last year. Starting this month, Google Pay users will be able to access Groupon deals, helping to connect small businesses with customers and really streamlining how users pay for those deals. Shares of Groupon spiked almost 10% on that news, but I think the market is still underestimating that boost to sales that this brings. Another catalyst here, and this one might take a little longer, but just potential acquisition interest from another company like Amazon or Google, it's a very real possibility. Now, Groupon has a great competitive advantage in that local retail market, you know, something that would complement a digital advertiser like Amazon or Google. Now, we already know Amazon is trying to work its way into physical retail stores, and this would seal the deal and make it the king of retail. Groupon's new CEO took over last month after heading up Zappos, an online retailer acquired by Amazon in 2009. So he not only knows how e-commerce works, but what Amazon looks for in a company. But then it's not just Amazon or Google that might want to go after Groupon. After a year of being locked down, people just want to get out and spend. That's going to drive that traditional retail sales and prove that brick and mortar stores aren't dead just yet. So Groupon's position in advertising in this part of the market can still be a great addition to any e-commerce advertising strategy, and shares are trading at a deep discount. It just makes a ton of sense that Amazon or Google would want to buy Groupon. And part of Groupon's problem is that it hasn't been able to build up that distribution to reach enough consumers or businesses, but folded into the billions of people visiting Amazon each month, and you would see sales skyrocket. In fact, if it doesn't get an acquisition interest from something like an Amazon or a Google, I think private equity could even step in here and take the company private and squeeze out that value. Now, there are just 3 analysts with price targets here, so I'm not sure I'd put a whole lot of faith in these. The average target of $28.67 is just 13% higher, while Morningstar rates Groupon as a 5-star pick with a fair value of $53 a share. Looking here into my E-Trade account, you can see I've been adding shares since that February 2020 sell-off and really accelerated that in August of last year as we started coming out of the pandemic. Now I have just over $38,000 in shares at an average cost of $25 each. You can also see here, when the price was reaching a peak right around last January, I sold covered call options against 500 shares at a $40 strike price. I collected $4,500 on the investment and reduced my risk, but those are going to expire this month and I'll keep that profit. I'll likely wait until the stock gets at least up to $35 or so before I sell any more covered calls or take profits. I think the fair value is closer to that point, with the potential to go as high as $50 a share on any takeover interest by Google, Amazon, or really any company that wants that exposure into the offline retail space. Click on the video to the right for the 5 best investments for 2022. 5 investments every investor needs to make and the 5 to avoid. Don't forget to join the Let's Talk Money community by tapping that subscribe button and clicking the bell notification.